سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل، فقد فاز المتقون. وأذكركم ونفسي بقول الله تبارك وتعالى: واتقوا يوما ترجعون فيه إلى الله ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت وهم لا يظلمون. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With his divine support, he gave us one more time. And it is a long time, inshallah. It will be a long time if we can make it in a couple more weeks or more to enter the season of training in which we will learn how to let Islam drive our footsteps in life, the only way of salvation and prosperity. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam taught us to pray by saying, Allahumma inni as'aluka sihhatan fil iman. O Allah, grant me and give me health in my faith, a healthy faith that will keep one firm and strong and never to be shaken by the currents of life. Wa as'aluka imanan fi husni khuluq. O Allah, give me the iman that will transform me into someone accepted by you and your people only through our akhlaq. And that is the fruit of Islam. When we will become accepted on earth by those who love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and by those who don't love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of the noble and the good character whom Muhammad alayhi salatu wa salam was and is the leader in that field. Wa innaka la'ala khuluqin 'azim. So it is time, and we need to know what to do in this time. It is a time when people are saying and making hashtags, hurt a Muslim. When people are saying and making a day to say, burn the Quran day. And others who are wise among the same team. When we are hearing a priest who is so-called religious leader, leading people to God, he claims he is teaching violence in the name of a man who never shown a bit of violence ever in his life. The Prophet Isa alayhi salam. This is the time, and what are we going to do about it? When they're saying, bear the Quran day, it is a time when we can see the universal soldier bombing and killing 150 children whose chest is full of the divine teaching, the Quran. They have been labeled as a terrorist. Why? Because they have Quran in their chest. And that does not please Shaitan and his team. Because this Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about it, wa innahu la dhikrun laka wa liqawmika wa sawfa tus'alun. This Quran is a dhikr for you. Dhikr here means sharaf, might, power, victory for you. If you hold on to it, wa liqawmi and your people, O Muhammad. Don't worry about Fir'aun, but worry about your connection to this world. And that's why the world, who cares? They speak about it. Why 150 children who did not even know anything serious in life yet, why their life have been taken? Why? Because there is something that will cause peace revolution in their life if they grow up with it. This is a time. What will we do instead? After that incident in Afghanistan, the children who survived, who are on their way to become Hafiz, they say to Pharaoh, what they say to Pharaoh in the past, لَنْ نُؤْثِرَكَ عَلَى مَا جَاءَنَا مِنَ الْبَيِّنَاتِ وَالَّذِي فَطَرَنَا فَقْدِ مَا أَنْتَ قَاد إِنَّمَا تَقْدِي هَذِهِ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا. We will never be afraid of you or prefer your offer to us over the offer of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do whatever you want to do. What can you do anyway? To take our life? You cannot do that. You can destroy this body, which is nothing. If you don't, one day it will be destroyed by itself anyway. Death is not death. The only way to die is when we follow the footsteps of shaitan. That is a real death. So the children who always, they were born in fight and war, they have been fought throughout their life. Yet, that did not disturb their journey towards the book that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent it down in the month of Ramadan. And the first word of it was to start a revolution against ignorance. Iqra, read, and with that, we can make it. And without it, we cannot make it. Because this is a time. What are we going to do about that? And I promised last week to talk about our youth, the backbone of every nation. Those youth who use their power and time to realize that I want to live up to the purpose for which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created me. As we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not create anything with no purpose. And everything's purpose is to serve the human being. And He created us with one purpose, to serve Him. After He made everything else that exists, to serve us. The sun is serving us, and we are greater because we can think, we can decide, but the sun cannot think or decide, and it cannot go out of its orbit. If it does, we know what will happen. And everything else, from the greatest to the smallest, for a purpose. Even the flies have purpose. The fleas, and even go lower to the atom, has a purpose. The electron has a purpose. The proton, and as lower we can go, it has a purpose. What about you, O human being? Our purpose has been announced in the heaven before we are created. And what was that? وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً. Behold, your Lord told the Malaika, I'm going to put a caretaker, Khalifa, who will subdue the earth and live life with purpose. Life that will produce something every day. And if we don't do that, it means we cannot justify our presence on the universe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We cannot justify we using His air to breathe, drinking His water, eating His food, walking on His earth, living His life, unless we do this purpose. And Ramadan is on the way. Just like today, came for that purpose. And you know it, and we all know it. The best we can do is to go back to that word Allah taught us to say, all of us. And when we are saying it, we think of each other. What is that? The general declaration we make in Surah Al-Fatiha. To say one thing that can decide or make our destiny. What is that word? Iyyaka na'budu. And we mention his name first before we say what we are going to do. To make sure that no one else we will surrender to. Nothing else. No one else we will recognize. No one else we will bow to except you, O Allah. And we seek your help to fulfill that promise. Wa iyyaka nasta'in. We ask your support to live up to our purpose. Because shaitan is walking every day up and down, to and fro, seeking whom he can devour. And we will say, not us anymore. We know our purpose in life. And we are young in our ibadah. Young means every moment we renew our Islam by saying again properly, this time I will mean it when I say, La ilaha illallah. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam told us to do so. Jadidu imanakum. Renew your iman from time to time. Wa kaifa nujaddidu imanana ya Rasulullah. How to renew our iman, O Messenger of Allah? Qala bi qawli la ilaha illallah. Repeat that vow again. Whenever dark clouds come into your life, or so many darkness surround you, say it and remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that darkness will go, but it depends how powerful you are in pushing it away. The Prophet Yunus alayhi salam said it when he was in darkness. He left a job and died. And then he suffered the consequences of leaving what to be done and done. But he said later, in that darkness, he still knew who to talk to for release. And he said, La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin. There is no God but you. No savior can save me but you. No power can save me but you. I admit, I did wrong thing. And of course, he was saved. How many darkness is covering our lives? We can say everything is dark. And a man is not a man until we have the power to rule. If not someone, at least to rule my own self. To be able to go against the current of my own desire and be able to say, I can at least control myself and I will willingly serve my purpose in life. And that purpose is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before the time comes, when we see, as I told you last time, when I went to Darwin, and I heard about someone whom used to sit in front of me just like any other kid. And always we know that. We want to see the growth of our children. And we want them to enter a time when we call them men. But what is the definition of a man? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us a hint in the Quran. يُسَبِّهُ لَهُ فِيهَا بِالْغُدُوِّ وَالْآصَالِ رِجَالٌ لَا تُلْهِيهِمْ تِجَارَةٌ وَلَا بَيْعٌ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَإِقَامِ الصَّلَاةِ وَإِيتَاءِ الزَّكَاةِ. This is a sign of a man. My business can never make my journey towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala short or ignored, and anything else. If business cannot, what about a plane? How can I call myself a man while a plane can make me ignore Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? That means we did not do the purpose of life. And some people, you ask them, what are you doing? They say, nothing. You stop there. Nothing? How can you be a person or even a thing by doing nothing? Then they say, but I'm a champion in soccer. I can keep the ball in the air for half an hour, never touch the ground. I'm skilled in that. Not only that, I even trained a dolphin to keep the ball in the air. And people call that a great man, champion in soccer, in volleyball, and any other things. But when we hear with the ears of our inside, Allah says something about that man. When we say, what a man, and Allah will say, what a man? Do you call this a man? Someone who went against the purpose of life and wasted it in play, and you call them the great people, the stars. This is the time in which we live. What will we do about it? And such young people, as we're talking about, who used to be a kid, 5 years old, 10, 15, and by the time they are 20, they are gone. Because Allah said in the Quran, وَمِنْكُمْ مَنْ يُتَوَفَّى. Some of you will be terminated. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will abort their life before they go into the age of being a full adult, right in the beginning, 20 years old. And this young man is gone with his muscle. That we will say and say, MashaAllah, if this is the muscle that Al-Qaqa bin Amr had, a man whose voice only by saying Allahu Akbar can make 1,000 heroes have wobbly knees, they go to their knees. Just because of a voice of one Sahabi, that was his muscle. The muscle of the faith. We want our young people to be like that. With that power, use it the way Umar bin Khattab did. Al-Qaqa bin Amr. This is the muscle of faith. Otherwise, it is time you will leave this universe when you are 21 years old. And why I pick up in this young man? Because 3 or 4 years in the past, we buried his cousin in this city, who also died when he was 21 years old. This is a time for us to remember them. To say, oh Shaitan, you can never devour me. I know the purpose of my life, and now things are happening. We can see the ayah I just said before. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described men, where can you find them? Fi buyutin adina Allahu an turfa. The only house in the Quran, Allah announced that it should be built in his name, only for his sake, is a mosque. Fi buyutin adina Allahu an turfa. Raise it up. Let the mosque be higher than any other building in our society. Let the mosque sound be louder in our minds than any other building in our society, because Allah wanted that way. And any noise to be made in that mosque, as the Quran said, وَيُذْكَرَ فِيهَا اسْمُهُ, Only his name will be praised and celebrated in it. And that is where we can create our soul. It is coming. It is already right there. So far, it is a building. The only thing will make it a mosque is when the mosque of Allah moves into it in his name. And the mosque of Allah is the human being that he built. Allah is the one who announces to happen. It happened because of somebody's idea, because of somebody's effort day and night, because of somebody's words, somebody's support. And many of you, if not all of you, have something to do with that building. If you say like 20 years ago, it will be there, you will say no. But now it is there. How? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used people. Because some of you have been chosen from the womb of your mother to come out into this world to make a change or something that will change many people's lives. And it is great to be chosen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah knows who to choose. الله يعلم حيث يجعل رسالته. موسى عليه السلام said many excuses not to be the messenger to Pharaoh. But Allah kept on telling him, you are the one. He used excuses. I'm not clear when I talk. Find someone else. Pick my brother Harun. He's more fluent than me. I did something wrong in the past by mistake. But Allah said to him, Ya Musa, inni istafaytuka ala al-nas bi risalati wa bi kalami fakhudh ma ataytu wa kum min ash-shakirin. O Musa, I have chosen you over the people of your time. So take my message and my words and be grateful to Allah by that. And this is a word to all of us. We take Allah's words and we will live. We will never die when we take these words. And be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by that. So this place is existing and it is already there. And Allah used many people for this to happen. We will die and that place will be there. And a new generation will come and continue the good work you have done. But this is the beginning of the challenge. When we will make it alive, stop there, Imam. What are you talking about? What type of a place is this? We come here many times to pray, and the gate is locked, and even you are not there. All of this is right. And we all need a fresh beginning, inshallah, with admitting our shortcomings. With a sincere people who never give up day and night, we can organize all of this. When we will have a regular mu'adhin, someone to replace the imam in his absence, because now we have a real place in which we can grow. And we all need to be part of this team that Allah loves. يُسَبِّهُ لَهُ فِيهَا بِالْغُدُوِ وَالْآصَالِ رِجَالٌ لَا تُلْهِيهِمْ تِجَارَةٌ ولا بيع عن ذكر الله وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة. And this is the time we can pattern to Bilal Luqman now when he was telling his son about the salah. Ya bunayya aqim salah. Take care of your salah in the best place. We have the chance now to say to our kids, in the time of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, sometimes he starts the salah and he will hear the cry of a child with the mother blood. And he will make his salat short. He didn't say the play of a child, or the running of a child, or the screaming of a child. That does not happen in a masjid. But a kid who cried for a meal or pain, and the mother need to pay attention. The Prophet used to shorten his relation with Allah, the salah, to respect the feeling of the mother who came all the way because she wants her child to grow in this type of places. It is good for her. So we have the chance this time to say, oh my son, oh my daughter, the only reason I bring you with me to this place is to grow, to learn what this place is all about. I will hold your hand with me. Don't run into the mosque. Don't play in it. Be silent. Pray next to me. And I will never let you run around. And when the prayer is over, we still don't play because people play sunnah. It is a moment of silence. This is the only benefit. Otherwise, I may be at the front line thinking I have khushu, and my baby at the back taking the khushu of the entire mosque. But now we have the chance not to deprive our children from understanding the mosque in Islam. Simply, I will sit next to me and pray next to me. What to do after the salah until we leave again? That way, we can create men who will know how to look after this place. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Hakim wa ja'alana wa iyyakum min alladhina yastami'una al-qawla fattabi'una ahsana aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullaha li wa lakum fastaghfiruhu innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. Alhamdulillah, thumma alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah alladhi hadana li hadha wa ma kunna linahtadiya lawla an hadana Allah. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. Dear Muslim, to summarize, I will share with you the advice of Ibn al-Qayyim when he said, إِذَا أَرَادَ اللَّهُ بِعَبْدٍ خَيْرًا فَجَّرَ فِي قَلْبِهِ عَيْنَيْنِ عَيْنًا يَرَى بِهَا الْجَنَّةِ وَعَيْنًا يَرَى بِهَا النَّارِ فَإِذَا رَأَى الْجَنَّةِ أَكْثَرَ مِنَ الطَّاعَاتِ وَإِذَا رَأَى النَّارِ ابْتَعَدَ عَنِ الْمَعَاسِي. When Allah wishes good with somebody, He will cleanse two eyes on their hearts. With one eye, this person will be seeing always paradise. The beauty of this world will never make them forget the real beauty of paradise. And they know that beauty, they will work hard to go to paradise. With the other eye, they see Jahannam. And they do their best to avoid going to Jahannam. This is a summary of what we're talking about. The Quran and Islam is for us to have a vision and become really alive. And we are alive only when we can go back to Allah with a sound heart. Allahumma fil al-Muslimin wal-Muslimat wal-Mu'minin wal-Mu'minat al-Ahya'i minhum wal-Amwat bi rahmatika ya arham al-Rahimin. اللهم أحسن ختامنا وأخرجنا من الدنيا مسلمين. اللهم انتصر للمستضعفين في كل مكان وعليك بالتقاة الظالمين فإنهم لا يعجزونك يا حي يا قيوم. وأقم الصلاة.